The Russian bounty story to me is, you know, another personal one that I was actually in government running the intelligence community for. And it's the third sort of circle of Dante's Inferno on this one, if you will. Basically, now you have the mainstream media politicizing the national security apparatus of the United States, which used to be the most apolitical system in government. And as a former terrorism prosecutor, as a former civilian in the military, and a national security official who ran the Department of Defense, that to me, I just didn't think that was ever possible by any components of the media. And the Russiagate bounty story, unfortunately, proved me wrong.
And just to super briefly recap what the Russian bounty story was, Russia was basically accused of paying bounties to the Taliban for the killing of American soldiers, and essentially the past administration was doing nothing, according to the story.
Right, and if you took that story as true, it's one of the most explosive wartime stories in modern American history. But I and Rick Grinnell were running the intelligence community at the time for President Trump, and we had access to all of the classified information and everything that was very sensitive. And we knew at the time that someone leaked this information, not only unlawfully, but as misinformation. We knew the real story, that there was no veracity to that reporting. And that's why no action was taken, and rightfully so, because the story was false.
So just to be clear, someone provided some intelligence about something like this happening, but you assessed it and found it to be false.
Well, not to speak to the intelligence itself, because it's still classified, but the Russia Bounty Gates scandal is another story where I believe the media knew the information they were putting out, that by making this story true when it wasn't, I believe they knew it was false, but they knew it would garner a headline that would damage the interests of President Trump and conservatives, so they ran with it anyway. And that's what I was speaking to earlier about this new tradecraft the media has developed to go out and politicize the national security apparatus of the United States of America, which is something they accused me of doing personally when I was running the intelligence community in the Department of Defense for President Trump. They accused President Trump and so many other individuals of doing that. But the hypocrisy of it all, as we've laid out here, is that they themselves, the media, are putting out misinformation and disinformation. But I believe the Biden administration had to correct the record.
So in this case, the Biden administration did correct the record. I believe an official basically said that it was detainee reporting that they had low to moderate confidence in. That's my rough recollection.
Yeah, they did. And for those folks who are wondering why we at the DNI, when Rick and I were in charge, didn't come out and immediately correct the record, it's because we were in the habit of not disclosing classified information. We were in the habit of doing our job and not politicizing the intelligence community. And it's about time the Biden administration came out and corrected a false narrative that they ran with for so long.
This actually raises kind of an interesting point. I've certainly heard a lot of people commenting on some Epoch Times stories and so forth. You know, why don't the people being accused defend themselves? You're telling me it's because they don't want to leak classified information.
Yeah, I mean, I can't tell you how many times I've been falsely accused in the media, and I don't just jump out there and correct the record, because to do so would require a disclosure of classified information, and I'm not going to do that.
So what do you do in this kind of situation?
You fight back through the legal process, as I'm doing, and you take people to court, take media companies to court for defamation, and force an unclassified disclosure of the truth. And that just takes time and money.